Years and years ago, actually just a couple weeks ago, I had the privilege of visiting Meteora. I was in utter disbelief at the landscape. The unbelievable presence of these Lebanon monasteries on top of these incredibly high rock formations. The view so breathtaking, the rock so high, I felt like I was about to meet the gods and live in my own Greek mythology story.
Back when the world was new, the planet Earth was down on its luck. And everywhere gigantic brutes called titans ran amok. It was a nasty place. There was a mess wherever you stepped, where chaos reigned and earthquakes and volcanoes never slept.
Woo! Say it, girlfriend!
And when a monk came to,
he hurled his thunderbolt.
He said,
lock those suckers in a vault.
They're trying on his own stock, chaos in its tracks. And that's the gospel time. Too tight and to just relax.
Why does this haircut make me look like a school teacher? Guys, I'm currently in Calabaca, about to visit the Meteora, which are a bunch of monasteries on top of really tall rock formations. Ever since I stepped foot in this city, all I've been listening to is Hercules gospel truth. Okay, every single rock formation that I see just reminds me of Hercules so much. I feel like I'm in a Greek mythology story. Seeing all of these rock formations, it's just so pretty to see in real life, guys. I'm not gonna lie, I had no idea what I was signing up for when I booked a hostel in this city. I realized afterwards that it's actually hiking central, that people go here to hike around the area. And I'm like, oh, what? That is kind of like the opposite of everything that I stand for, which is utter hatred for hiking. So how's that gonna work? Looking at the rock formations, it looks majestic. I don't know, well, maybe this is going to single-handedly convince me that hiking is not that bad.
And now here I was on my way to Meteora on a bus. So from now on, I'm going to give more information in my vlogs because I realized watching back some of the vlogs that they felt a bit empty. And I kind of wish they were more, you know, informative, especially if you guys are interested in visiting the same places. Now, as you can see, I went to the first monastery by bus. There are actually many ways to get to the monasteries. One of the most popular options is by hiking, as previously mentioned, which I will discuss this a little later. Next is by car. Seeing all of these cars parked outside of the monasteries, I could just feel the frustration of every driver trying to find parking. Save yourself the headache and just don't rent a car. You can use a taxi, but it's pretty expensive, around 15 euros to get to the highest monastery. So again, would not recommend. Next, you have a public bus line. One-way tickets are €1.60. It leaves only 3 times a day from the Calabaca bus station, at 9, 12, and 4 o'clock. If you are leaving from the Roussanos bus station, just know that the bus sign is somehow underneath this hotel sign, which confused the hell out of me. Did someone not think before putting on the sign that this would be confusing as hell? And then finally, and the last option that I actually recommend the most, but I'm going to tell you that later because I'm a bitch.
Gorgeous. I am so happy that I came here. I am so happy that I made this take because this is the best take I've ever done. I literally had no idea what I was signing up for, and I'm so glad that I came here because, oh my god, in real life, this is stunning. Oh my god. I feel like I'm an avatar, Greek mythology story. I'm just like in awe. This place is gorgeous. If you ever have the chance of coming here, you have to, because I just cannot believe this is a real thing. This is a real place. Oh my god, I get to spend the rest of my day here. Oh my god, I am so freaking excited. Oh my god, I'm so happy that I came here. We'll be right back.
stories in front of a landscape that looks as if it came out of a Greek mythology story. Like, that is such a vibe. The vibe is vibing, guys.
This place is crack, okay? It's so majestic. Seriously, magical and majestic. These are the two words I would best use to describe this place.
And while we're on the topic of monasteries, let me tell you a little something about them. In the 10th century, monks used to live in these scattered caves all over the cliffs. If I was them, I would have jumped. Not out of suicidal thoughts, just out of sheer curiosity, because I really wanted to experience what it's like to fall off a cliff. They would often get donations from local residents to help them survive. One day, a monk decided to organize Sunday meetings where the monks could pray together and share the donations. From then on, in the spirit of seclusion in the 14th century, a guy by the name of Athanasius built the first monastery, the Great Meteoron. He is considered as the founder of Meteora and the monastic life of the area. As you can see, we are currently in Varlaam. Varlaam was actually started by a guy who climbed all the way up to the top of the cliff, followed by other monks, and decided to set camp there. You know, sometimes with religion, I am so confused as to where they get their tradition from, because I don't remember anything about rock climbing in the Bible.
You're going to eat bread, drink wine, and rock climb the El Capitan while doing backflips on the wall to show your loyalty to me.
By the way, I am wearing a shawl around my hips because they require every woman to wear a skirt. Also, entrance is 3 euros for every monastery, and every monastery has varying opening hours. Start with the biggest one, the Great Meteoron, because it closes first. Okay, now I have to tell you about my favorite thing. So when the monasteries were built to get the monks from the ground to the monasteries, they would have these rope sacks or rope man traps where the monks could go in them and then be lifted off using a barrel up top. I have to experience this once in my life.
Literally my dream, okay? Like, as someone who loves mildly extreme sports, I am so excited just by the thought of it. Monastery of Varlaam, make this a thing. Make this into an attraction for the monastery.
But despite my utter astonishment at how beautiful Varlaam was, how breathtaking it is, combined with this beautiful, charming terrace, there is something that kind of traumatized me.
In shock at the goriness that I've just witnessed. I don't know what the fuck happened in that church, but there were so many depictions of like decapitation and people getting murdered and like people getting hanged. What the fuck? Like, did I just go into like a horror movie? Okay, I was not expecting it. I literally went on a rant about how beautiful Orthodox churches were, and every single Orthodox church I visited never leaves me different. I'm always flabbergasted and in absolute admiration at how intricate and just exquisite the churches are. And then out of nowhere came all of these depictions of decapitation, people getting murdered, people getting hanged. I was like, what the fuck did I just walk into?
Cappuccino Fredo. Oh my, seriously, like, Cappuccino Fredo is the best thing in the world. I just don't know how I'm going to live in a world without Cappuccino Fredo. Like, iced coffee from Tim Hortons is not even remotely close to how beautiful and how exquisite Cappuccino Fredo is. I have been grieving, preemptively grieving the day that I'm going to have to say goodbye to Cappuccino Fredo and live in a Cappuccino Fredo-less world. No! That was freaking incredible. The monasteries were so beautiful. Unfortunately, it's about to. Oh my god. I'm so scared. Okay, I'm so scared of it raining. Give me a 2-hour window for me to go back down, and then afterwards you can rain all you want, rain, but not right now. Oh my god. Thank you.
much needed rest and the rain dying down, I decided to walk up to see the sunset over Meteora, severely overestimating my hiking capabilities, but that is a problem for later. Now let's talk hiking. If you go to one of the Visit Meteora office, they will give you a map that details the trail you will have to take. Basically, you just have to walk on the main road in Kalambaka that will then lead you to the village of Kastraki. Continue onto that main road, which eventually turns into a hiking trail. The trail has barely any infrastructure in it, so when I was walking on it, I legitimately thought that I was walking towards my death. If you are on something that looks like this, a track that's perfect for a serial killer hideaway, you are on the right track. As you go along the trail, the path will intersect with the main road. Once you reach that road, just go up to see all the monasteries. The hike is around 2.5 hours without any stops.
Oh, fuck, bitch is. Okay, yeah.
And now, onto the last way of getting around Meteora, the option that I recommend the most, motorcycles. You can rent one for 20 euros for 24 hours, and oh my god, if you can, take that option because it is transcendental. You get to see all the monasteries, the scenery, at a way faster pace than you would with walking, but you still get to be close to the natural landscape on like a car. You won't lose your mind trying to find parking because they're significantly smaller than cars, duh. There's also so many observation decks that don't have much space for car parking, but are perfect for storing your motorbike for a couple minutes and admiring the beautiful scenery. Did this trip convince me to hike? No! It just reaffirmed to me that hikers are nut jobs. But it convinced me that I need to learn how to ride a motorcycle. I actually befriended a guy at my hostel who told me that I could hop on the back of his motorcycle. Now you may think, girl, that is so dangerous. But I say, girl, he's a hamburger. A guy from Hamburg, Germany, okay? I feel like Germans, they got their shit together. They don't make mistakes except for the Holocaust or fumble, like on a really good basis. I just trust them. So if you ever visit Meteora, ride a motorcycle. If you can't, find yourself a German guy who can, because there is no such thing as a German serial killer. Don't quote me on this, I am not liable for anything. I was hanging out with my new best friend. Okay, look at me not being a hermit and actually socializing. I didn't vlog as much, so let me tell you about my experience. St. Stephen was bewitching. The monastery has some of the best views of the rock formations, but also an incredible perspective on the neighboring city of Kalambaka and Kastraki. We could actually see our hostel from that viewpoint. At the back lies a beautifully lush garden that only adds to its picturesque quality. Despite being surrounded by greenery, I cannot get enough of the greens. However, in spite of visiting such a scenic monastery, my trauma followed me.
The decapitation continues. There are so many paintings of people getting decapitated, skinned alive, stabbed, hanged. I'm like, what is going on with these monasteries? I love the Orthodox churches. This is actually worrisome. Do these monks need therapists that can like train them, that can like help them to become more at peace with their seclusion? Maybe being secluded from the entire world has made them go crazy, and that's why there's so much depiction of people getting decapitated.
That's a lot of decapitation and people getting skinned alive.
Three theories as to why there's so much depiction of decapitation, murder, people getting skinned alive in all of these monasteries. Number one, seclusion has made all of the nuns and all of the monks go crazy. Number two, hiking up top of these rock formations has made them go crazy. Number three, dick and pussy deprivation has made these people go crazy, which is why the only thing that they can think of is to decapitate, murder, and skin people alive.
The next and last monastery I went to was actually a nunnery called Holy Monastery of Roussanos, and this one was cute, but tiny as hell. We had to walk an excruciating path to get there. Okay, maybe I am exaggerating. For a normally healthy person with a normal lung capacity, this walk would be a cakewalk. But for me, seriously, unfit girl who hates any type of physical exertion, no, that walk was a nightmare. The nunnery made a point of not being allowed to take pictures or videos, so it did not take much. There's a small basin giving some information about the monasteries and a balcony, and that's it. So honestly, I would skip it. If you have the time, by all means, go for it. But if you are limited on time, you can pass this one. If you ever have the chance of coming to Kostroki and Kalambaka, do it. You have to visit this insane phenomenon in person. Just coming into the city, I couldn't close my mouth in awe. This place, as I said, feels grand and magical. Meteora is the epitome of breathtaking. It is hard to wrap your head around the fact that this place exists on Earth. It constantly reminds you about how mind-fuckingly beautiful Mother Earth can be. And yes, I made that word up. That's the impact of Meteora. So breathtaking, no words in the English language can describe her splendor. You have to come up with nuance. Sometimes, with these gorgeous landscapes, you can get tired looking at them after a while, but not with Meteora. You never get tired of it, especially if you have gospel truth playing in the background.